We're back with a deeper look at the new game mode for Madden 21 The Yard. I'm going to show you all the customization options, create my character, show a little gameplay, and also go over some of the info about the console version of the game mode that just was released by Game Informer. They did a brief article on it, so you'll see some things going on in the background here. This is the mobile version, but it's going to be very similar to the console version in terms of customization and things like that. I do believe the console version will offer more. And I think both versions are going to have many updates throughout the year. But right now, what you're seeing is kind of the celebrations that you can, you know, equip to your character for your intro, for when you win the game, for when you lose the game, for when you score touchdowns. Now, I just started, so I don't have all this stuff unlocked. A lot of these things unlocked by reaching a certain level, and then certain ones you need to reach a certain level and then spend some of the in-game currency that you earn by playing the game to purchase and unlock these things. Things like celebrations, gear, and all that good stuff. So from what I've seen, at least from the mobile version, it doesn't seem like a pay-to-play type deal. It seems like everything can be earned by just playing. It's very easy, it seems, to kind of upgrade to different levels. And like I said, you unlock different things. So these are just me looking at the celebrations now. Now, for the console version, they did actually reveal something pretty interesting. It is a 6-on-6, however, in terms of actually playing head-to-head, the most users you can have on a team is 3. So it says here, the goal of The Yard is to let players experience fast-paced gameplay of backyard football. Players create a custom character, choosing their facial hair, hairstyles, and more, then outfit it in unique gear. In The Yard, the players can pull off trick plays like behind-the-back throws and double passes, and compete in new field locations all over the world with various rule sets. Once you step onto the field in The Yard, you compete in 6v6 games, either solo, online co-op versus the computer, or online head-to-head multiplayer options. The online head-to-head allows for teams consisting of 1, 2, or 3 players. The Yard features new animations and a post-launch plan to include new gear, drops, and all of that stuff throughout the NFL season. Playing in The Yard grants your character experience points and other rewards, and of course you can link between mobile and the console version with your rewards. So you see here, just continuing to create my player. I did think there would be like more hairstyles and more options for that to start, but I would hope that they add more throughout the year. This is something it looks like they're going to do a lot of downloadable content for. Not downloadable, but like via patches and title updates, they're going to add new gear and stuff, kind of like how NBA 2K and NBA Live used to do it. So this right here is like, you kind of can set your home and away uniforms. It's like it's a loadout, you're just base uniform. Now you can see again, most of them are locked. Some of them, again, you unlock as you progress. And mobile, it's just CPU only. You play versus the CPU. But on, like I said, on console, you can play versus other people. Now, the kind of big thing is they said you can only be 3 versus 3. We thought it was going to be 6 players versus 6 players. Sounds like it's six players versus six players, like actual players on the field, but it's only 3 human players versus 3 humans. So maybe you can control multiple players, kind of like how you do in squad. You can kind of jump around and control multiple people. I'm pretty sure that's how it's going to be with this mode as well, which I kind of think 3 versus 3 is better, just because 6 versus 6, kind of the logistics of that are kind of tough, getting 12 people into a matchup. So here is like, you can edit your jersey. Now you have your jersey loadout, but now you can edit it. Do you want your jersey rolled up, the Ezekiel Elliott look? Do you want it tucked in, or do you want it untucked? I went with the untucked. And then you see you have all these other base layers. So if you do roll your jersey up, you can put these hoodies or other types of things on, and it'll extend out past your rolled up jersey. And it's just like another layer of customization. I'm sure there's going to also be a point where you can take the jersey off and just wear like hoodies and t-shirts and things like that, I would assume. You also got back plates and things like that. So again, if you have the jersey rolled up, you could have the cool back plate showing on the back end. I don't have any of them unlocked yet. Again, by playing through, you have a kind of like a level. You go up level 1, 2, 3, 4. I think it goes all the way up to 32. And you can, at each level, you unlock new gear, new animations. And as you play, you earn cred and like in-game currency that you can also spend in the store to buy stuff. Not microtransaction based, it's all in-game currency that you earn by playing. At least that's what it seems like so far from what I've played. And you know, you can also spend that to unlock stuff or go to the store to buy new stuff. And as the year goes out, they're going to release more stuff that you can go use your cred on and things like that. So as you can see, I'm just kind of playing around with the customization. I have the Saints helmet because I did select the Saints as my favorite team when I started up the game. So you can put your favorite team's helmet with like one of the custom jerseys if you want. You could see you got the arm sleeves, you got tons of gloves, you know, you got shorts you can add. So you can see none of these are unlocked yet, but You could either wear the football pants or you could wear shorts or sweatpants. There's a decent amount of gear options to start the game. Like I said, I would have liked to see more like hair and like facial hair type stuff to customize. It didn't seem like that was too in-depth. I would hope on console they would even have face scanning would be even better, but it's EA, so I'm not going to hold my breath. But you could see to start the game a decent little amount of customization. They did say that they were going to be working with brands as well. So I believe they're going to be doing drops throughout the year and updates. Like you're going to get Nike gear, Adidas gear, and stuff like that. Again, same thing you see in NBA 2K, same thing that they did in NBA Live. They even would do things with other brands. Like I know in NBA Live they had like Bathe and Ape clothes, if you're familiar with that brand and stuff like that. So those are things you can maybe expect to be coming to put on your character as well. You can see a lot of cool cleats and stuff here. It's really just all about playing through and unlocking these things for your character, because obviously in the beginning it's a little bit more generic, but as you raise your level and as you earn more cred, you can unlock things. Now here's the cool thing. You see face masks, you see visors, and you see mouthpieces. Now people have been asking for colored visors and mouthpieces in the game for I can't tell you how long. I don't know why they haven't been in the game yet. They are clearly in the yard mode, so what I wonder is, are these things going to be added to the regular game that you can equip to players, let's say in like a franchise mode or something? As you can see, all the colored visors here, again, not all of them are unlocked. Some items are considered common, some items are considered rare. I guess, I don't know, those things, just the things that look cooler, they might cost more, or that you need to get to a higher like level to unlock them. They did that in NBA Live as well, but you can see a decent little amount of visors and mouthpieces to start with. So I wonder if this is going to be in the regular game too, or if this is just exclusive to the yard. I think that would be silly if it was just exclusive to the yard. If you could add it to the yard, I feel like you should be able to add it to the regular game too. Now here's where you pick your archetype. There's different types of QBs, running backs, receivers, and tight ends. I went with a deep threat wide receiver. And you can actually raise your level up. It says level 2 right there. You could raise it all the way up to 99 to see what your stats will be like when you reach a 99. So you could see like what your max speed all that'll be as you upgrade your player. But again, here I actually went and bought these shorts in the store because I had a little bit of the in-game currency. Don't really know how I earned it because I'm not familiar with Madden Mobile. I think by just starting up the game in the mode, it gave me like a little bit of credit for starting, so I went and equipped that. So that's kind of what I look like to start. Nothing too crazy, but when the game comes out on console, or when console comes out, you know, I think it's going to be pretty much more in depth in terms of customization. I think they're going to offer more things. It's going to also be multiplayer, which again, this is just solo. It's one-on-one, which is kind of boring. So here in this first game, this is like the story mode you go through. There's a little bit of like story that goes along with it, but I skipped over that because it's kind of boring in the mobile version. So here was just 1st-to-6 wins. We scored 6. My running back took it to the house, broke a tackle. So here we are, and you can see at the end of the game here, this is like all your in-game credit and your rep and all that stuff, your level, all that stuff gets added each game. So then, you know, you can go spend that after the game, or if you're saving up for something special, you know, you save up after a few games and you go buy new stuff for your player, which I think is cool. I think all of us as gamers like when you can unlock everything through the game itself. You don't want to have to spend money to feel like you got to keep up. You like the fact that you could just play the game. So you could see I unlocked a new uniform just after that one challenge here. So not too crazy, and I'm already unlocking stuff. But I don't really like this uniform. So I just, honestly, the generic uniform they got you with, I feel like is the best looking one. Honestly, I hope they put better uniforms in the game, because I have to say the uniforms they start with, most of these are kind of ugly. I think the base ones are the best looking ones, the ones that they give you. So here it's the 1st-to-8 to win. So we got a score, a touchdown, and a 2-point conversion to win the game. And it's just, you know, the story progresses. I only played a few matchups, but you go through the story, and I'm sure it gets a lot much more in depth than this. But the console version, I believe there's going to be a story version as well that you can play, which is good for like just hurrying up and leveling up your guy quick and earning things. Here we get stopped on a 4th down because I'm just a bum. So now we got to go play defense, and I don't know how to play mobile at all. So don't laugh at me, because I don't know how to play mobile at all. This is like so different than playing on console, like controlling it from your phone. I mean, as you can see here with my user, I don't know what I'm doing, and I give up a touchdown. But again, on the console version, I think there's going to be a story mode, a career mode, like integrated into it as well. But you can also, the main thing is going to be playing that head-to-head online, 3v3. I think it's going to make for some good content. A lot of YouTubers will probably be teaming up and making videos versus each other. I think it'll be a lot of fun for sure. And that's really going to be the selling point of the mode, in my opinion, is the head-to-head. It's the same thing with 2K, right? Like, the park is the biggest thing in NBA 2K, and it's because you can go on there, play 2v2, 3v3, and things like that. If you were just playing on the park versus the computer, it wouldn't be nearly as fun. It just honestly wouldn't be. So I think, you know, if you want to do offline, you can do the career mode. If not, you can go online and play versus other people and just kind of have fun that way. And I'm just curious to see what they're going to do in terms of all the customization, the new things they're going to drop, because it said it in the article, they're going to be dropping new things throughout the year. That's kind of what games do now. You know, they want to have those updates where they're releasing new post-launch content, because it's expected from games now. And Ultimate Team was the only mode really doing this for so long, but now other modes and being added to the game like this and KO, and they're even talking about doing it for franchise as well. You want to start adding stuff for the rest of the game. So that's it. That's kind of a more in-depth look at the yard, the customization options and things like that, a little bit more of the gameplay. Hope you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you're new. Bell icon's on. Got a lot of good content coming over the next couple weeks. And as always, I will see you guys next time.